Okay then, let's take a bit of time and talk about Python IDEs. Before I get into that, what is an IDE? Well, very clearly it's an integrated development environment. And in the shortest and simplest terms, that means it's a package or an application that we use to write our code. So when it comes to Python IDE, obviously we're writing Python code and we'll be writing our code, testing it, using built-in debuggers and other features all within that one IDE package. Now, when it comes to picking a Python IDE, clearly there are lots of choices, but let's kick off by talking about maybe my favorite. Now, for me, it has to be Visual Studio Code or VS Code, depending on what you've heard it referred to as. Why is that? Why do I like Visual Studio Code the best? Okay, well, first of all, it's lightweight. And I think that's really, really important because for a lot of people, they don't necessarily have the most powerful machines. And a lightweight application that doesn't bog down or burden your system can be really helpful and help you get the best out of your coding time. There's nothing worse and having a really complicated project and your computer is struggling because the application you're using to write that project is actually so onerous and requires so many resources. One of the other great things about it, which you may have heard about already, is extensive plugins support. So basically you have a range of extensions. Think of these like browser plugins or other things that you're familiar with. And you can install these within VS Code and you can tweak it and tailor it and get all these extra features. And when it comes to Python, that could be a linter, formatter, maybe you're using PEP8 and you can have an automatic formatting system that whenever you save your file, it will format it in PEP8. So you keep on top of that, debuggers, and also AI coding assistance, which I think we'll come back to later on in the video. Also, like you get with most applications, you can customize the interface, so you can tweak it to suit your workflow. And you can also use VS Code built-in themes, which are one of its greatest features. Actually, you can tweak the layout and the look of VS Code to really suit your own personality and your own flavor. And of course, you've got built-in Git integration. Now, if you're any form of developer that's taking it seriously, at some point you will encounter version control, and Git is usually what we're all using for that. So built-in Git support is really great, and it makes it easy to track our changes and also to collaborate on projects. Okay then, now something we should point out is that one size does not fit all when it comes to picking the best Python IDE. Yes, I've just made a case of VS Code, why I really like it, but that doesn't mean it's the best case and the best tool for you, because every project and every user has different needs. So it's important to think about which IDE suits your projects and needs. Maybe your company even has a tool that everyone uses, so you have to use that tool and you have to get familiar with it. Now, when it comes to Python, one of its most popular utilizations and use cases is really data science, especially in the last 2 years. If you've heard about Python, chances are you've heard it related to data science. And one of the greatest options for data scientists is the Jupyter Notebook. Now, you may already know about this, you may not, but let's quickly run down what you get when you use Jupyter Notebook. Now, one of the most important features is the idea of running code in blocks, and then you get to see these results instantly. This is amazing for experimenting with data because you can do things and instantly see your results. And you can obviously share this as well with maybe students that you're working on a project with or members of your team at the company that you work for. You also get one of the great things with Jupyter Notebook, which is visualization integration. So with libraries like matplotlib or seaborn, which you may be familiar with if you have done any data work Python, you can instantly see your plots and charts output within Jupyter, which is really, really helpful. Honestly, it's a fantastic feature. And also you get markdown support. So you can mix code with narrative text, equations, and visualizations all in a single document. So again, every use case has its own needs and requirements. And if you're doing anything with data, maybe if you're new to data science or you're learning in particular, Jupyter Notebook is a great place to spend your time. So perhaps VS Code isn't the greatest start for you, and maybe Jupyter Notebook's the place to go. But they aren't the only options. What else could you consider? Well, when it comes to Pro Tools, what do you think is the number one amongst most Python users? Let's think about that now. Well, maybe you're already familiar with JetBrains, and in that case, you might be familiar with PyCharm. Now, this is in many ways the pro tool for Python developers. For professional developers, especially in web development or working with large code bases, PyCharm is so powerful. So it's a go-to. And I've got friends and colleagues that use PyCharm in their day-to-day coding because that is what their company requires them to use. So again, you've got this concept of depending on where you work, you may have to use the tool that is the go-to in your firm. But that isn't to say it isn't a good tool to use. And there is a free version, which is great too. So you can use the free version and really get to grips with PyCharm. Some of its best features are that it's got intelligent code completion, which is fairly standard, but all the same, it does a great job with this. Deep code analysis and a really powerful debugger. It's also got built-in framework support. So you've got class, another Python framework, so you can use straight away within PyCharm. And there are built-in database tools, which is great if you're a back-end developer working directly with databases. So again, PyCharm is well worth considering. I've used PyCharm, and sometimes I do use it VS Code, depending on the project. But on the most part, my preference is VS Code, just how lightweight it is. But I do really appreciate PyCharm and just how slick and well-designed it is as a tool. Now, I mentioned something earlier, AI coding assistants. Let's come back to that now. Now, you've probably noticed that AI is everywhere, right? It's absolutely everywhere. We've all noticed AI. Everyone's creating AI tools. AI is finding its way into all of our day-to-day lives, especially as developers, AI is becoming very prevalent. And in many ways, the most important tool for us outside of, say, going to ChatGPT or another LLM and asking for help is to use an AI coding assistant, which is essentially an extension or an extra feature that we can add to our IDE. And we can use tools like GitHub Copilot, Amazon Code Whisperer, Tab9, etc. And we can get built-in coding support and assistance within our IDE. And this is often touted as an AI pair programmer. And what it means is that you can write comment and ask it to do something for you, and it'll actually write all the code out or give you very detailed auto-completion of your code. So rather than just filling in a variable, you can start writing a function with a descriptive name. And the AI coding system will actually flesh out a draft of the function for you. I mean, it's really powerful stuff. And I think as time goes on, developers are all going to be getting very used to having this as a day-to-day part of their arsenal. So for me, my suggestion would be to consider an IDE that already supports AI assistance, because if it's where the future is going, you don't want to invest your time into an IDE that doesn't natively support these, because you may have to switch in the future. So VS Code, full support for GitHub Copilot and other AI plugins. PyCharm is also great for this and has its own option for an AI coding assistant, because JetBrains released their own. So you could use Copilot or the JetBrains option. So I would say, when you're thinking about picking your favorite IDE or the best IDE for your use case, yes, think about what you're trying to do, but also think about the future and where coding is going, and make sure that you're set up to take advantage of that. So final thoughts for me really are that there is no one best IDE, but there are some great candidates that you should probably consider as your shortlist options. And remember that the right IDE might come down to things that are out of your control, such as company policy or project requirements. And, you know, projects might have the requirement for certain levels of consistency, so you have to fall in line with whatever they're using on the project. But that's great, because sometimes getting to grips with different IDEs can give you an understanding and an experience of something you would never have otherwise had. And that might open your eyes to something that you realized you need, but you didn't realize you needed before. So my advice is try out a few, see which one fits your workflow, and also keep an eye on how AI tools are evolving, because you want to integrate that as well.